Come on, everyone, let's go. Where? To the world of plants. Come on. How lovely it is here. There must be millions of plants here. Brightly colored, spotlessly clean flowers. All kinds of fruits. Vegetables. Trees. How beautiful they all are. Let us now have a closer look at the members of this world. Let us learn how they reproduce and see what techniques they use. You all know that even giant trees grow from a tiny little seed. But do you know where these tiny seeds come from? I was once just a tiny seed, too. I am really curious to learn just how I came into being. In order for a seed to form, the female cell inside the plant has to combine with a male reproductive cell from another plant, in other words, with pollen. But how do they manage that? Plants can't move. You are right, plants cannot move, but God has created various ways by which pollen from one plant can reach another. A lot of pollen is carried by the wind. Some people don't like this because these tiny grains cause a lot of people to suffer allergic reactions in the spring. Achoo! I get this every spring. A grain of pollen starts turning into a seed when it reaches that part of another plant containing the egg cell. Some plants use special carriers to send their pollen to other plants. The most common of these are insects. Flowers produce food that insects like and attract them with their bright colors and perfumes. That means they are able to pass on their pollens to them. They then carry those pollens to other plants. The harmony between these different life forms becomes clearer when we have a close look at the relationship between flowers and insects. Here is one example. This flower, which grows in southern Africa, is known as the iris. It is very difficult for carrier insects to reach the food and pollens made by this attractive flower. But look, there is a long tube under its leaves. The food and pollens are all at the bottom of this tube. The insect that will carry the pollens also needs a long tube to reach them. It is like us using a straw to drink from the bottom of a tall bottle. And here is an insect that can reach this plant's pollen, a hoverfly. Thanks to its long tube or proboscis, it can reach right into the depths of the flower. And it can hover in the air like a helicopter. Special signs are used to enable a helicopter to make a safe landing. Do you wonder if the hoverfly has anything similar? Let us have a closer look now at the white arrows on the surface of the flower. They are all pointing to a single spot and showing the hoverfly which way to go. The hoverfly is thus able to make a successful landing at exactly the right spot. Let us now think about what we have just seen. The flower is an unconscious part of an unconscious plant. It has no eyes, ears, hands, or brain to think with. Yet, it has signs on it telling the insect which way to go. The flower itself is even unaware of these. As for the insect, it has no consciousness or intelligence either. Yet it possesses all the special features it needs to reach the pollen. It is Almighty God who creates the flower and the insect to be compatible with one another. God knows what characteristics every living thing needs and gives them the most appropriate ones. God reveals this in our holy book, the Quran. Everyone in the heavens and the earth belongs to Him. All are submissive to Him. Flowers that give off perfumes. Some plants use a quite interesting technique to attract insects. They offer them perfume. This orchid that lives in South America produces a special perfume in its leaves. The customers for this scent are male bees. Human beings use perfumes to smell nice too. Ooh, that smells so good. Bees want to smell nice, just like humans do. When a bee arrives to take perfume from the orchid, the flower also gives the visitor its pollens. How? Let's have a look and see. The entrance to where the perfume is very slippery. The bee loses its footing when it gets here and slips. Whoops! As it struggles to free itself, it makes contact with the yellow pollen. And the pollen sticks to its body. Seeds emerge shortly after the pollens reach the female cells. Friends, the seed will allow the plant to have offspring of its own. Every seed is an example of the creative artistry of God. Almighty God, the creator of all things, reveals this in the Quran about the creation of the seed. Have you thought about what you cultivate? Is it you who make it germinate, or are we the germinator? If we wished, we could have made it broken stubble. Thank you. Flying Seeds. These seeds you are looking at now spread by flying through the air. There are some 100 seeds under every white puff. These seeds have a special system enabling them to fly. Look how pretty they are flying about, just as if they had parachutes. This parachute is so effective that seeds can float in even the very slightest breeze. Each of these tiny helicopters you are watching carries one seed. The size of the seed is just right for the length and shape of the wing. This system, too, works just like a parachute. It is intelligent, educated human beings who design parachutes. However, parachutes so much more efficient than those made by human beings are used by plants. And they are all just plants. They have no intelligence or consciousness, but thanks to God's matchless creation, they have perfect parachutes for their seeds. Winged seeds. Come on, let's go to the Amazon rainforest. Oh, it's really hot here, and there is no breeze. It must be really hard for seeds to fly here. Yes, it is very difficult for seeds to fly in such hot and windless air. That is why the trees here use perfect wings to send their seeds off to other places. The tree's seed is right beneath the wings you are looking at. These wings can carry seeds for long distances on even a light breeze. Thus, the seed travels a long way from the tree it originally belonged to. Plants that use helicopters. Some trees use helicopters to get their seeds to fly. Look, look! Thanks to those wings, the seeds are floating through the air. If this blade were a bit smaller, the seed would fall to the ground, but in fact, it is just the right size. And the weight of the seed is just right for the blade to carry. Some helicopters have more blades, and the system used is exactly the same as that used by human beings. The American aircraft designer Igor Sikorsky developed the first helicopter inspired by these seeds and their flight system. Thanks to the blades, the seed travels long distances. This means that the tree is able to have its own offspring. It is a miracle how a tree with no mind or consciousness, consisting of a wooden trunk and leaves, can make such perfect wings. Could such features come about by chance? It is the height of insanity to claim that such perfect features could come about as the result of chance. There is no doubt that God created these trees, their seeds, and the aircraft to carry them. In one verse of the Quran, God tells us, "Your deity is God alone. There is no deity but Him. He encompasses all things in His knowledge." Plants that fire off their seeds. Some plants use really fascinating ways of dispersing their seeds. Some fire them off into the air. This is a squirting cucumber. Thanks to a special system created by God, the seeds are kept under high pressure. And when the time comes, boom! This is the Himalayan balsam. This system functions so perfectly that the slightest touch triggers the firing system. The force applied is quite strong, and this means that the plant is able to fire its seeds up to 5 meters or some 16 feet. Plants that use vessels. Friends, some plants use water to disperse their seeds, not just the air. So their seeds are able to travel in water. This plant is the sea bean. Its seeds are some of the best able to travel in water. Friends, traveling in the water is no easy matter. Each seed has its own special packaging. This means they can separate from one another and travel in different directions. The seed you are now watching is about to embark on a long journey. Look, the river current is carrying it towards the sea. It will reach the sea after a journey of many kilometers. Its casing acts as both a raft and a protective covering. This journey that will continue in the ocean may last for months or even years. And the seed will stay alive despite the difficult conditions in the ocean. If the sheath is damaged, its hard shell will continue to protect it. Eventually, it reaches dry land, where it will settle and continue with its life. A new sea bean tree will begin putting down roots thousands of kilometers away from the parent tree. Plants that make friends with ants. Do you know what the hardest working insects in the world are? Ants, of course. Ants are the most diligent and hardest working insects of all. Plants sometimes take advantage of ants' industriousness and use them to carry their seeds. In return, they give the ants a special reward. Their seeds have a fleshy covering which provide food for ants. If the seeds are left out in the open, then birds or other creatures will eat them. So they need to go underground as soon as possible if they are to survive and grow. The ants are at work. Ants are carrying the seeds underground into their nest. They eat the nutritious food around the seeds, but don't touch the seeds themselves. So, the seed makes its home underground, where it can grow in safety. Fruit trees use a similar technique. They use human beings and animals to carry their seeds. When the seed ripens, the fleshy pulp around it changes color, becoming sweet and delicious. It literally invites human beings and animals to break it off. Birds cannot resist these fruits and eat plenty of them. Let's think again now. Plants use soil, water, and the sun to produce delicious fruits for us. They make healthy foods as if they knew what human beings and animals need. What is more, they produce these fruits in such a way that this enables dispersion of their seeds. Don't forget, trees consist of wood, roots, and leaves. They have no powers of thought or reason. Yet they produce really delicious and nutritious foods for us and animals. It is Almighty God who created us and all other things, who also enables trees to make fruits in this way. God calls on us in a verse from the Quran. It is He who sends down water from the sky, from which we bring forth growth of every kind, and from that we bring forth the green shoots, and from them we bring forth close-packed seeds, and from the spathes of the date palm, date clusters hanging down, and gardens of grapes and olives and pomegranates, both similar and dissimilar. Look at their fruits as they bear fruit and ripen. There are signs in that for people who believe. Conclusion. In this film, we have been looking at seeds and pollens, which are a miracle that most people are not even aware of. Flowers that guide insects. Insects that have been specially created for these flowers. Orchids that provide bees with perfume. Seeds that use parachutes, just like engineers. And seeds able to withstand journeys in water lasting thousands of kilometers. We have seen some of the interesting techniques that plants use to make other creatures carry their seeds for them. We have seen that these systems in plants are too perfect to have come into existence by chance. It is Almighty God, the All-Knowing, who regulates all of this. It is He who knows the creation and needs of plants and places other means at their service. God calls to us on this subject. God is He who splits the seed and kernel. He brings forth the living from the dead and produces the dead out of the living. That is God.